Hello students, welcome to Rationality classes. Today I am going to do exercise 8.2 of NCERT class 10 maths. So in exercise 8.2, it's all about plugging in the values of standard angles of trigonometric ratios. Like you will be given a trigonometric ratio with a certain value. You have to plug in the value of sine 60 if you remember it. So let's revise what we have learned earlier about the values, about the standard angles. So these were the standard angles: 0 degree, 30 degree, 45, 60 and 90 degree. You just need to remember the first one, the the values of sine theta corresponding to the standard angles. So you just need to learn the first one, and I will show you how you can find the values of other trigonometric ratios with standard angles by simply applying some techniques. So let's go. So sine 0, 0, sine 30, half, sine 45 degree, 1 by root 2, sine 60 degree, root 3 by 2, and sine 90 degree, 1. Yeah. When you are finding the cos theta of the same standard angles, you just need to revert. You just need to revert the values of the standard angles. Like if sine 90 degree is equal to 1, then cos 0 degree is equal to 1. If sine 30 degree is equal to half, then cos 60 degree is equal to half. Similarly, and when finding tan theta, you just need to write tan theta in the form of sine theta by cos theta. Like what is the value of tan 0 degree? It will be equal to sine 0 degree, which is 0 by 1, which is again 0. What is the value of tan 30 degree? Say it is sine 30 degree by cos 30 degree. You divide these fractions and you will end up with 1 by root 3. That's how you will find the tan theta. And cot theta is the same. You just need to revert the order of the standard angles of the tan theta. And sec theta, you just need to take the reciprocal of cos theta of the standard angle to find the sec theta. And cosec theta is all about the sine theta. You take the reciprocal of sine theta. And I just want to introduce with these important formulas. You'll be applying it in one of the questions today. It's sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1, cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. I'll teach you the proof in some other classes. You just need to learn the formulas for now, okay? So let's move on to the questions. So wait. Hope you get a better view of the question. So let's solve the first question, which is sine 60 degree cos 30 degree plus cos 30 degree plus sine 30 degree, sorry, cos 60 degree. How will you solve it? You just need to memorize the values I have told you earlier. If you have memorized the values, you know that sine 60 degree will be sine 60 degree will be root 3 by 2, cos 30 degree will be again root 3 by 2. Let me show you. Look, sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2, cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2. Similarly, you can find the value of sine 30 degree by learning. It's half, and cos 60 degree will be half. Multiply it, root 3 is a 3, 2 to the 4, plus half into half is 1 by 4, 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4 is equal to 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. So the answer of the first question will be 1. You just need to plug in the values, nothing complicated in here. Now let's move on to the fifth question. The rest questions between 1 to 5 are all same. You just need to put in the values of the trigonometric ratios and you will get it. 5 is also the same, but it is presented in a more complicated way. Okay. So what is the question? It's 5 cos square 60 plus 4 sec square 30 minus 10 square 45 degree. And in the denominator we have sin square 30 degree plus cos square 30 degree. Cos square 30 degree. So let's solve it. So in the numerator in the numerator we have 5 cos square 60 plus 4 sec square 30 minus 10 square 45 degree. Now you transfer the square into the whole square term. You transpose it like 5, you write cos square 60 as cos 60 whole square, and you write 4 sec square 30 as 4 sec 30 whole square. Sec square 30 and sec 30 whole square are basically the same. So you write 10 square 45 as 10 45 whole square. And in the denominator we have sin square 30 plus cos square 30. Look, according to this formula, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. You put in any values of theta like 30 degree, sin square 30 degree plus cos square 30 degree is equal to 1. Sin square 60 degree plus cos square 60 degree is equal to 1. Sin square 45 degree plus cos square 45 degree is equal to 1. So you put any values of theta here, you will get 1. So similarly, according to the formula, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Sin square 30 plus cos square 30 is equal to 1. So you just write 1 in the denominator. And now, you just need to put in the values of these trigonometric ratios. What is the value of cos 60? It's half. And since it is inside the square, you need to write half inside the square. Like this. Plus, what is the value of sec 30? So I showed you the formula how to remember the values of other trigonometric ratios by knowing this only the values of sine, standard angles of sine, which is now you know the values of cos 30. Values of cos 30, it is equals to root 3 by 2. It is equal to root 3 by 2. What will do with the values of sec 30 then? It will be the reciprocal of the cos 30, which is 2 by root 3. Write 2 by root 3 here. And since it is inside the square, write this inside the square too. 10 45 degree is equal to, let me write this in rough. 10 45 degree is equal to sin 45 degree by cos 45 degree, which is 1 by root 2 by 1 by root 2. Root 2 and root 2 will cancel out and you will get 1. So you will get 1 whole square by 1 in the denominator. So let's break the squares now. 5 into 1 square is equal to 1, 2 square is equal to 4. Plus 4 into 2 square is equal to 4 and root 3 square is equal to 3. Minus 1 square is equal to 1. You just need to simplify it. 4 4 is a 16 by 3 minus 1. Take the LCM of 4, 3 and 1. It will be 12. 4 3 is a 12. 3 5 is a 15. Plus 3 4 is a 12. 4 16 is a 64. Minus 1 12 is a 12. 12 is a 12. Just write the answers now. What is 15 plus 64? 4 plus 5 is equal to 9. 1 plus 6 is equal to 7. Minus 12 by 12. 79 minus 12 will give you 60. 9 minus 2 is 7. 67 by 12, which is the final answer. Get it? That question 2 is similar to this question. You just need to plug in the values. And let's move on to the question number 3, which is slightly different from the above two questions. You are given with the given information 10 a plus b is equal to root 3 and 10 a minus b is equal to root 3. These two given information. And you need to find the values of a and b. How will you find it? Let me show you how. First, write the solution. Write the given given 10 a plus b, sorry for my hand, 10 a plus b is equal to root 3. Okay, so we can write root 3 as in the form of 10. Can you remember how? Write root 3 as a form of 10. See, 10 60 degree is equal to root 3. So you can write root 3 as 10 60 degree. 10 a plus b is equal to 10 60 degree. Right? Now cancel the 10 from both sides, like uproot the 10. You will get a plus b is equal to 60. Write this as equation 1. Similarly, let's write the second given equation. Also, given 10 a minus b equals to 1 by root 3. So you write 1 by root 3 in the form of 10. How do you write it? Yes, according to this table, you see that 10 30 degree is equal to 1 by root 3. So you can write 1 by root 3 as 10 30 degree. 10 a minus b equals to 10 30 degree. Eliminate the 10 from both sides and you will end up with a minus b equals to 30. Put this in equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and solve equation 2 by any method you like, method of substitution, elimination, comparison. I personally use method of elimination. You add up both the equations, 1 plus 2, you will get a plus a twice a plus b minus b equals to 0 and 60 plus 30 is equal to 90. We get 2a is equal to 90. Transfer the 2 in the right hand side, you will get 90 by 2 is equal to 90 by 2. You find the value of a as 45. Now you have to simply put the value of a in equation 1. Let's see. Equation 1 implies, put the value of a in here. What is the value of a? It's 45. 45 plus b equals to 60. So b, you write 60 minus 45 and you will end up with, what is 60 minus 45? 15. So you get the value of a plus b as a and b as 45 and 15 degree, right? Therefore the required values of a and b are 45, a equals to 45 and b equals to 50. Get it? So this is it for today. Meet you in the next class. Thank you.